Hi guys, welcome to the video number 17th of the video series Forced Vibration of Single Degree of Freedom Systems. In today's video, we are going to derive the equation of motion of a damped spring mass 1 degree of freedom system with harmonically excited base. Now previously, we have done the derivation of equation of motion of a spring mass damper system in which there was a force which was actually a harmonically excited force, but the base of the mass was fixed. The base of the entire system was not moving, it was not having any motion. Now in today's video, we are going to see the effect of the harmonic motion of the base onto the entire spring mass damper system. Right, so we have removed the harmonic excitation force and we have taken the harmonically excited base here for the same spring mass damper system with 1 degree of freedom. And now we are going to see the equation of motion of such kind of system in which the base is moving with certain harmonic motion and we have the spring mass damper system with 1 degree of freedom. Right, so to have the derivation, we should take some parameters. So let us assume the system consists of following parameters. Now, which are that parameters? The first one, we are going to assume the spring with spring stiffness or spring constant K in Newton per meter. The system should also consist mass M in kg. The system should consist a damper or a dashpot. Damper with damping constant. Damper with damping constant C. And what is the unit of C? Newton second per meter or kg per second. Now other than this, we are going to assume the base with the harmonic motion, right? So we need to have a parameter of base with harmonic motion. So we need to consider a base with harmonic motion and we'll assume the motion to be y, which should be a harmonic motion actually. So I'll assume some things. I'll take it as y, capital Y, sine omega t. Right, so I'll assume a base which is moving with the motion small y equals to capital Y sine omega t, where this capital Y is the amplitude of the motion of the base, omega is the frequency of the motion of the wave base, right, where this capital Y is the amplitude of harmonic motion of the base right, and omega is the frequency of base motion और दी हार्मोनिक मोशन ऑफ बेस राइट। अच्छा व्हाट विल बी द यूनिट ऑफ द एम्पलीट्यूड, द यूनिट ऑफ द एम्पलीट्यूड विल बी द यूनिट ऑफ द मोशन विच इज मीटर। एंड व्हाट इज द यूनिट ऑफ द ओमेगा, द फ्रीक्वेंसी, द यूनिट ऑफ ओमेगा इज रेडियन पर सेकेंड। रेडियन पर सेकेंड राइट। सो नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू ड्रॉ द सिस्टम, जस्ट हैव अ लुक टू द सिस्टम एंड देन आई विल ड्रॉ द फ्री बॉडी डायग्राम ऑफ द सिस्टम। सो वी हैव अज्यूम्ड फोर पैरामीटर्स ऑफ द सिस्टम। टिल नाउ वी हैव अज्यूम्ड फोर पैरामीटर्स ऑफ द सिस्टम right now I'll draw the system diagram. So previously what kind of diagram we were drawing, a fixed end, one spring, one dashpot, both are connected to the mass right, this kind of diagram we were drawing previously. Now here what we are going to take, this fixed end with certain harmonic motion right. So I'll keep other things as it is and I'll provide a base with certain harmonic motion. So because I'm taking the base with certain harmonic motion, mass should be upward of the base right. So I can say mass should be supported on base, mass should be supported on base and base should have a motion. So this is the mass M, this is the spring, right, this is the damper, the spring constant of the spring is right, the spring constant of this spring is K, the damping coefficient is C for the damper and this is the base with certain motion. So this is the base with harmonic motion. This is the base with harmonic motion, y equals to capital Y sin omega t right. So this is the system we have. Mass is supported on a spring and on a dashpot or damper and the entire system is supported on a base which is moving with a harmonic motion y sin omega t. Now initially I'll assume the motion of this mass also in certain direction, I'll assume the motion of the base also in certain direction right, and I'll show that motion in the free body diagram along with all the forces. So now we'll see the free body diagram of this entire system when the base is having a harmonic motion and the mass will also move with certain harmonic motion. So right now in this free body diagram, this is your mass M. Right. Instead of spring, I should show the spring force. Instead of damper, I should show the damping force. Now I'll assume the mass is moving in upward direction, and the motion of the mass is x as a function of time in upward direction. I'll also assume the base at this instant of time is also moving in upward direction with the motion y as a function of time, right? So what I have assumed that mass is moving in upward direction with the motion, with the displacement xt. I'm also assuming that the base is moving in upward direction at this instant of time with the motion yt, right? So initially we were taking this base to be fixed. So yt was zero initially before, when we were taking the example of a forced vibration kind of system. Here the base is having certain motion. The displacement of the base is yt when the displacement of the mass is xt, right? So now this is my mass here. So instead of this spring, I should show the spring force. Now if I am drawing the free body diagram of the mass, where should I draw the spring force? Upward or downward? See, you can simply think that whenever the mass will be moving in upward direction, the spring will resist the motion of the mass in upward direction, right? So the mass will exert a vertically downward force in the spring. The same thing will happen to damper also. When the mass will try to move upward, this damper will provide a resisting force in the direction negative to the upward direction, that means in the direction downward, right? So the direction of the spring force is downward. The direction of the damping force is also downwards. So here I'm going to draw the downward spring force. This is downward spring force, and this is downward damping force, right? And the motion of the mass is in upward direction. This is the direction of xt, the direction of x dot t, and the direction of x double dot t. Means the velocity, acceleration, and the displacement of the mass is in upward direction. Now what will be the magnitude of the spring force? Previously, when the base was not having any motion, the yt was assumed to be zero previously, so the spring force was kx and the damping force was cx dot. Now here, when the base is also moving with certain displacement yt, the velocity y dot t, and the acceleration y double dot t, right? So in that case, at any point of time, the net displacement of the mass will be xt minus yt. Initially it was xt minus 0, right? Right now it is xt minus yt. At any point of time, the net displacement I am talking about, the net displacement of the mass is, I'll write these points here, the net displacement, the net displacement of the mass at any point of time is xt minus yt, which is actually x minus y, right? Which is x minus y, right? So I can write the velocity, the net displacement is x minus y, net velocity of the mass at any point of time is equals to x dot minus y dot, just the differentiation of this displacement, it means x dot minus y dot. And what about net acceleration of the mass at any point of time? Net acceleration of the mass at any point of time, the net acceleration will be x double dot minus y double dot, right? So at any point of time, the net displacement of the mass is x minus y, the net velocity of the mass is x dot minus y dot, the net acceleration of the mass is x double dot minus y double dot. Previously, when the base was not moving, it was having the motion zero, that means yt was zero previously. So when you are going to put this y to be zero,
the displacement of the mass will become x, the velocity will become x double dot, and the acceleration will become x double dot, right? So that's the case we were going to get previously when there was the base with no motion. Now the base is moving, that's why we are going to have the displacement of the mass is x minus y, the velocity as x dot minus y dot, and the acceleration as x double dot minus y double dot. Now talking about the spring force, the spring force will be k into net displacement of the mass. K into net displacement of the mass. Now what is the net displacement of the mass? X minus y. So k into x minus y is the spring force. Now what about the damping force? The damping force is c into net velocity of the mass. C into net velocity of the mass. Now what is the net velocity of the mass m? The net velocity of the mass m is x dot minus y dot. So that the damping force will be c into x dot minus y dot. Here the damping force will be c into x dot minus y dot. So this is the spring force, this is the damping force. Now this is our mass m, which is moving with the displacement xt, velocity x dot t, acceleration x double dot t, right? Now we can easily apply Newton's second law of motion or D'Alembert's principle to this system to get the equation of motion. So this figure is the initial configuration, the configuration of the system. This figure is the configuration of the system. Right? And this figure is the free body diagram of the system. That means FBD of the system. So we know that the equation of motion can be derived from the free body diagram. Alright, so I'll erase the configuration diagram of the system, and with the help of free body diagram I'm going to derive the equation of motion. We can apply Newton's second law of motion or D'Alembert's principle to get the equation of motion. I prefer Newton's second law of motion. Right. So now applying Newton's second law of motion to the system. Now what is Newton's second law of motion? Vector sum of all the forces is equals to mass into acceleration, right? So I'll take the acceleration in x direction so that the force should also be in x direction only. Now here the direction of the acceleration is upwards, right? So that will be my positive direction. So in writing the equation of motion, the positive direction will be the upward direction. This direction is the positive direction, means all the forces which will act in upward direction are going to be taken as positive forces, because the acceleration is in upward direction, and all the forces which are going to be acting in downward direction, that has to be taken as negative forces. What is the reason? Because the acceleration is in upward direction, that's why I'm going to take this sign convention, right? Now spring force and the damping force both are acting in downward direction. Mx double dot means the effect of the entire vector sum of the forces is in upward direction. That means I can write minus k into x minus y minus c into x dot minus y dot is equals to m into x double dot. The spring force is acting in downward direction. That means the spring force has to be written as minus k into x minus y. The damping force is acting in downward direction, that means it has to be written as minus c into x dot minus y dot, and that should be equals to mass into acceleration is in upward direction, that means mass into plus x double dot I should write. That is ultimately mx double dot. Right. Now I'll just simplify this one. So this is equals to minus kx plus ky minus cx dot plus cy dot equals to mx double dot. Or I can write this equation as mx double dot. This minus kx I'll take this side, so this will become plus kx. This minus cx dot I'll take that side, so this will become plus cx dot. And that should be equals to what is left here now? Ky plus cy dot. This is left now. Right? Now, here we know the equation of y. The equation of y is capital Y sine omega t. That means what will be y dot? Y dot will be differentiation of y sine omega t. That means the differentiation of y into sine omega t. The differentiation of sine omega t is cos omega t. Cos omega t into omega. So I'll write omega first here only. That means omega into y into cos omega t. This is y dot. I have the value of y, I have the value of y dot. I'll put them here in this equation. So I'm going to get this equation as mx double dot plus cx dot plus kx equals to k into capital Y sine omega t plus k into omega capital Y into cos omega t. Right? Now, this is not k, this is c omega y. Now this is some term multiplied by sin omega t plus this is some term multiplied by cos omega t. So I can get this entire expression in any of the four forms. What are that four forms? Either sin omega t plus phi. I will not take phi here, I will take alpha here. So I can take this form into sin omega t plus alpha. I can make this form into sin omega t minus alpha also. I can make this form in cos omega t plus alpha. I can make this same form in cos omega t minus alpha also. Based upon what the value I am going to take for the ky and c omega y. Right? So because we are taking the base excitation to be y sin omega t, I'll prefer sin omega t plus alpha kind of form. Sin omega t plus alpha kind of form I'll prefer. Right? So I'll assume this ky to be, I'll assume the k into capital Y to be some a cos alpha. I'll assume omega c y to be some a sine alpha. Right? Then what can I write for this entire expression? Now I can write this expression to be mx double dot plus cx dot plus kx equals to, instead of ky I'll write a cos alpha. So a cos alpha I have written sin omega t as it is, plus instead of c omega y I have written a sin alpha here and cos omega t as it is. Right? So here I got a sin omega t cos alpha plus a cos omega t sin alpha I got. Now if I am going to take a amplitude common, so I left with sin omega t cos alpha plus cos omega t sin alpha. Now what can I write for sin omega t cos alpha plus cos omega t sin alpha? I can write this to be sin omega t plus alpha. So the expression will become mx double dot plus cx dot plus kx equals to a sin omega t plus alpha. Right? So now this is the required equation of motion which I need to solve. For the case of damped spring mass system, with 1 degree of freedom and with harmonically excited base or base with harmonic motion. So this is the required equation of motion. In this equation of motion, I just need to get the value of amplitude and alpha, and this will be completed. So now here, once I am going to get mx double dot plus cx dot plus kx equals to a sine omega t plus alpha as my equation of motion, how I can get the value of amplitude a? So see what I have done. Here I will square this entire expression. So this will be omega c by whole square equals to a square sine square alpha. Right? It will be like this. Right? Now I'll square this expression. So this will be ky whole square equals to a square cos square alpha. Now I'll add them. So it will be a square sin square alpha plus a square cos square alpha equals to ky whole square plus omega cy whole square. Now what is sin square alpha plus cos square alpha? That is equals to 1. So I'll get a square equals to square root of, a square equals to ky whole square plus omega c by whole square. This I'll get for a square. The value of a square I got is equals to k by whole square plus omega c by whole square. Right? And now how to get alpha? How to get alpha? See what I'm going to do to get alpha. This was my first expression. And this was my second expression. So I'll divide the equation number 2 by equation number 1. So it will be AA will be gone sin alpha by cos alpha. Sin alpha by cos alpha will be omega CY by KY. YY will also be gone. So if I'll divide equation number 2 by equation number 1. So YY gone, AA gone. Here I'm going to get this division. Here I'm going to get sin alpha by cos alpha as tan alpha. And tan alpha will be equals to omega C by K. Right, tan alpha is equals to omega c by k. So what can I write for alpha? Alpha will be equals to tan inverse of omega c by k. Right, alpha value will be equals to tan inverse of omega c by k. So I got the value of a, I got the value of alpha. Now this equation of motion is completed. So the equation of motion for the system damped spring mass 1 degree of freedom system with harmonically excited base or base with certain harmonic motion is equals to mx double dot plus cx dot plus kx equals to a sin omega t plus alpha, where a amplitude is equals to square root of ky whole square plus omega c by whole square, and the value of this alpha is equals to tan inverse of omega c by k. Now what is this a? A is the amplitude of the base harmonic motion. Right. I should not write like this because I'll express this in some other form. So what I'm going to take this, I'm going to take this as capital X1 I'm going to take. So instead of A, I'm going to take this as capital X. Why I am writing this to be capital X1? Just for the simplicity, right? Because A we have taken for the case of harmonic excitation force, right? And here we are going to take harmonically excited base. So better to take this to be X1, not as capital A, right? Right. So the equation of motion is mx double dot plus cx dot plus kx equals to capital X1 sin omega t plus alpha, where the value of capital X1 is square root of ky whole square plus omega c by whole square in meters. Remember, it is in meters because it's a kind of amplitude of the motion. So it will be in meters. And the value of alpha, which is the phase angle of base harmonic motion and the motion of the machine, is equals to tan inverse of omega c by k, right? So this is phase angle in between the motion of the base and the motion of the mass,
right?
So better to write this as phase angle only, right? So alpha, the value of alpha, which is the phase angle, is tan inverse of omega c by k in radians. So now this is the end of the video number 17th, that is forced vibration of single degree of freedom systems. We have completed the topic, equation of motion of a damped spring mass 1 degree of freedom system with harmonically excited base. And the result of this derivation is this one, where the value of x1 is this, value of alpha is this. Thank you.